अज्ञान विराम नष्ट ज्ञान अंजन श्लाघया चक्षुरुन विनितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे वंशा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्यनाम गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय कदालये कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय भक्त्या विहीनाय अपराध चेताश्च कामादितरंग मध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणं यं प्रव्रजन् तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्य द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वो गिरेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानुपुष्ट तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयमाम चरणं discussing something. What is pure bhakti in our learning process? From the book of Srimad Bhakti Nautha, Bhakti Tattva, though is like a very booklet, but very powerful. All doubts will go and we will know what is pure bhakti. And then we can engage ourselves in devouring pure bhakti. Then there will be no chance to fall down. Then continuously we will go develop our Krishna. I think in this modern age, after Sat Goswami, up to Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, only Bhakti Vinod Thakur is also very powerful. Acharya in this world. And that is why he is called Bhagiratha, who brought Bhagirathi Ganges in the shape of the same flow of Bhakti river from Rupa Goswami. That is why he is called Seventh Goswami. So it is so easy to read. All the books of Jiva Goswami and all others are in Sanskrit and so rich language, and some philosophical terms are there. It is very hard to know something. But from the books of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, the essence of all the Goswami are in the books of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Especially in Jaiva Dharma. Jaiva Dharma is the last book of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So he has taken all the essence in a very little part. Whole ocean of bhakti has been given in very little part, he has tried. And it is not so very hard to go through them. So, I think that it will be proper for you all that if you want to realize the writings of your Prabhupada, Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, and Jiva Goswami and all others, first we should try to go through Jayodhara. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has translated and he has explained explanations, bhashya of all the books of Goswami, commentaries of all. So when I joined Math, Guru Maharaj, my kindly suggested me to read first Jayodhara. Now what I am telling, only by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur through Jayodhara. And then I read Srimad Bhagavatam, Satsandarbha, all the books come, Govinda Bhashya, and all the books of all Goswamis. So, very easy, the books of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So in modern classes, I will try to give some essence of the literatures and all kinds of established truth in modern class. The process. Yes, explain two kinds of process. One, taking and other, giving. Those who are favorable, we should accept. And those who are unfavorable, we should give up. So in the teachings of Upadeshamritam by Rupa Goswami, first he has told that what are unfavorable, they should be given. And what is favorable, we should accept. Now I am coming in the sweet pastimes of Krishna. I think that these are more powerful. More powerful. If anyone has pure Shraddha, transcendental faith, and with that faith anyone is hearing, so with so honor, and so strong belief, these Hari Katha, or from a powerful devotee who is Niragi Bhakta. From Niragi Bhakta. There are two kinds of Bhakta. Bhakta means speaker. Niragi and Saragi. Saragi is those who have some worldly desires to feel, some attachment in world. And by Hari Katha they want to test all these things. They are Saragi. If anyone hearing that Hari Katha, momentarily there will come something. But it will not be steady. It will go away. But those who are Niragi, having no attraction to worldly desires, to taste all these things, and having some realization, and his perfect in all Shastra, Prabrahmani Nishna, and Prabrahma, and also in Sabda Brahma, Sabda Brahma is Srimad Bhagavatam, and Parabrahma always engaging himself, observing himself in chanting, remembering, thinking, like this. Then he is Niraga Bhakta. Like Sukadeva Goswami, Parikshit Maharaj, like Gadadhar Pandit, like others, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they are Niraga Bhakta. Then there will be no chance of falling down. Never. So, Harikatha will come through our ears, pure ears. and it will be in the shape of Krishna himself. And then he will clear our heart. And he will make himself a seat, very good seat there. And then we will realize something. So, before beginning our Srimad Bhagavatam, sweet Harikatha, we will have to do prayer to Srila Sukadeva Goswami. Yan praprajan tamanupetam apetakrityam dvaipanayana virahakatara ajbha putreti tan maya tarvobhinedu tan vyasthi. Once all the pure rishis and munis assembled in Naimisharanya, Kali was coming. Krishna has left this world with his all associates in Braja, Dwarka and all. So all Kali was coming. So all were very fearful. What to do now? Time will come very hard. What should we do? And in the meantime, Sut Goswami came there and he became Vyas to tell Harikatha. Saunak and about 88,000 of the rishis, Muni, all were assembled there. And they asked, especially for the human beings in Kali, these two, when all will quarrel among for worldly things, so many wars will go away. The human being, even male and female, will give up their religion and anything. All will be engaged in worldly matters, mating and all other things. How should we do? What we should? कैसे हमारा कल्याण होगा श्रेय ये सब टाइम हाउ वी विल बेनिफिट देन ही डिड दिस प्रणाम एंड बिगन श्रीमद् भागवतम यं प्रव्रजन तमनुपेतम अपेत कृत्यम आई एम doing namaskar to my Gurudev, to Srila Sukadeva Goswami, who is all pervading. He is in atoms everywhere, because Krishna is there, Srimati Radhika Kanjivasa, everywhere, and all atoms, trees and creepers, even human body, everywhere there is no place where he is there. So to serve their this conjugal, all the bona fide gurus are there. All bona fide gurus. In Baladev or Nityananda, always they are. Krishna without Baladev Prabhu never exists anywhere. So our guru must be there. So Sut Goswami is telling that my Gurudev is all pervading everywhere, serving his consumers. But don't see that our Gurudev is dead. He never dies. If he is bona fide Guru, never dies. No question. So he is doing pranam, that you are everywhere, inspiring Krishna Bhakti in all. I know that when you took birth, no ceremony was there, no cutting of death, no jat karma was there. What is jat karma?
A biblical court.
Cutting the umbilical cord.
Yeah. And clearing and taking bath and all these things. So many cows giving donation and all these things. There was no shame. And I fancy quickly left that place. And then his father Vyas began to cry, "Oh son, where you are, where you are, oh son, oh son." And all the trees in Oko replied, "Oh, who is son, who is father? Who is mother, who is son, who is sister?" Valli mohe vahi karan. Valli, attachment is the cause, root of all these things. Why you are complex? So trees are replying in echo. Who is this Sukadeva Goswami? Who is telling so sweet? Even Narada is present there. Even Vyasadeva is there. Parashar is there. All are there in the council of Parikshit Maharaj. But all requested Sukadeva Goswami, who was naked. Why they? So we should know that who is, who are Sukadeva Goswami. He was the parent of Srimati Radhika. Srimati Radhika always used to keep this parrot with her everywhere. She has a golden case. Sometimes out of case, sometimes in case, and sweetly caressing, and just to tell, "Oh, you should repeat me, Krishna, 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 Krishna." And the parrot in the same voice, so sweet voice of Srimati Radhika, they are totally following them. If you, in our village, there was a person who kept a parrot. And sometimes he used to go to his house, home. "Oh, kaun hai? Kaun hai? Who are you? Who are you? Stop it. Nonsense, nonsense. Go away, go away." Sometimes. And he used to say, "Oh, who is this?" And in the voice of his master. "Oh, he is anywhere hidden and telling like this?" But after some, "Oh, you that this parrot is dead." And somewhere these parrots like Ram, 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 Radha Krishna, Radha Krishna, like this, in a very sweet voice. It depends on the master who teaches them. So this parrot was with Srimati and she was giving him her pomegranate seeds. Reddish, like pearls. And sometimes he used to give milk and very long rice, basmati chawal. Very sweet, very tasty. And he used to take and to follow Srimati Radhika. Krishna, Krishna, in the same sweet voice of Radhika. Anyone cannot distinguish whether Srimati Radhika is telling, uttering or he is uttering. One day she was doing so and he was repeating Krishna, Krishna. But he flew from the palms of Srimati Radhika. Very near Nandagaon. Both each other. Only there is difference of two fingers. The border of Nandagaon and border of Darshan. Plenty of so much kadamba trees in Nandagaon and plenty of Tamal Krishna in Barsana, Tamal in Barsana, and some Kadamba trees there. But it may be some Tamal trees in Nandagaon and some be Barsana Kadamba, but very little. We have seen in Nandgaon about thousands and thousands of Kadambakhandi there. Kadambater also, where? Kadambater, where Krishna used to take his flute and climb on the top of that tree and used to tell, oh, Shyamali, Gauri, Kalindi, calling all the cows, and sometimes in the midnight, oh Radhike, oh Lalite, oh Vishakhi, oh, like this calling. This is called Kadamba Te. So everywhere, still now, but so many have expired in the separation of Krishna and Radhika. So that terror came in Nandgaon and sat on the branches of any tree, tamal tree, because they like tamal tree, because Srimati Radhika likes tamal tree. And the color of both are like same, and began to speak, utter Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. And Madhumangal was at that time playing with Krishna. So Krishna then heard that, oh, from where Radhika came? And he began to search Radhika, where is Radhika? And calling me Krishna, Krishna. But he could not see. Then he saw on the tree branch that, oh, very beautiful parrot with reddish nose.
Big,
very beautiful, and he saw. Then he began to utter Krishna, Krishna, and after some moment he began to tell, "I am so unworthy, so unworthy, and akritagya, ungrateful, by nature because we are birds. I was sitting on the palm of Srimati Radhika, always curiosity in me, giving and sweet advices, and so much loving, always. But I'm so ungrateful creature that I left Srimati Radhika. And coming here, fire on me. Krishna saw that, oh, she's lamenting, he's so much lamenting. He told that, come on, in sweet voice, my dear parrot, come on. And seeing this, he at once came on the hands, palms of Krishna. He began to caress, and that, oh, so, please tell what you are uttering. Then she began to talk. Oh, Krishna, Krishna, I am so ungrateful creature. I am so I am very low.
Unfortunate.
And ungrateful. I was playing on the palms of Srimati Radhika and she was so much giving me so much honor, so many sweet things, and I have left her and I have come to here. So fine on me. Hearing this shloka, Kavi Karnapu has written that shloka. Very beautiful. And he began to be that parrot. Krishna told that, oh, you have come to me. And you should repeat this time to me. I want to play with you. I want to also give rice and sweet and pomegranate seeds.
Pomegranate.
And you should be with me. When they were doing, loving their parrot, at once two sakhis came, Lalita and Vishakha. They were so much worried for that parrot. They went to Krishna and told, Oh, my dear Kanhaiya. This parrot is of Radhika. True. Its name is like Vichakshan. Vichakshan. And he is very sweet to Radhika. This parrot is life and soul of Radhika. If you are taking this and keeping with you, she may die. So please at once give this parrot. We will take it and give it. And she is so worried for this. He told, Krishna replied that, if it is your sukh and your Srimati's sukh, then you can call, and if he is going easily to you, you can take it at once. They try so much that, oh parrot, come on, come on, Srimati is calling you, but he was very peaceful in the hands of, and sometimes calling Krishna, Krishna. Krishna that told that, it seems that this parrot is not your Srimati, it is mine. Then you can call and if he is going, no more. But I will not give him in any case. He may go. They tried hard but failed. They entered in the council of Srimati Yashoda Devi and told, oh mother, Yashoda. And they do pranam. Yashoda told that, oh, you seem very worried. Why you are so worried? They began to tell all the history that the parrot of Srimati Radhika has come here flying and it is playing with Krishna is playing with him and he is not giving us. So Radhika may die for this. She is so worried. She has left his food and taken water, everything. So it must come to us so that we can be returned to Srimati Radhika. Then Srimati Yashoda told us, oh my daughters, you should wait a little, don't worry. And he at once went to Krishna and Madhumangal and they were playing with that, oh, you should repeat what you were telling and hearing and giving something to eat. In the meantime, Yashoda came at once and took the bird very forcefully. What you are doing? And to stoop the ear of Krishna twisting, oh, Nand Baba is waiting for you to take Mahaprasadam and you are here with birds and so many animals and you want to be animal and birds, oh, this will come. And he took the hands of Krishna, taking Krishna forcibly. And Madhumangal was telling, like she seeing what is happening. At once he came and he seated here and he came in the room where the two girls were waiting and she, oh, take it. And at once he used to go there and then later. So you can think that how and who was this Sukh, but how he became in the shape of a man, this parrot. You know that all the birds, all the serpents, all the animals, deers, everything of Krishna Loka are transcendental. All are transcendental. It has been written by Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, Yat kinchetrani gulmaki katamukham goshte samastam vitat सर्वानंदमुकुंददयितं लीलानुकूलं परं शास्त्रे रेणुमुहुर्मुहुर्निष्टङ्कितं ज्ञञ्च ब्रह्मादेरपि शास्त्रिहं ततो सर्वं मया इदं वन्दते. रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी डूइंग वंदना टू ऑल क्रीपर्स, ऑल ट्रीज, ऑल द एनिमल्स, इवन टू अ स्कॉर्पियन, इवन टू स्नेक्स एंड ऑल. व्हाई? ओ, यू आर ऑल एसोसिएट, ट्रांसेंडेंटल एसोसिएट ऑफ कृष्णा. You can give Krishna bliss and Krishna bhakti, pure bhakti. So I am praying to you all. How a snake serves Srimati Radhika and Krishna conjugal. Once Srimati Radhika was in anger, And he was ready to go from Krishna to his Radhakunda from anywhere in Govardhan. And he was quickly going, returning. And Krishna was so much worried for that. He wanted to stop Radhika, not to go in. But she was very strongly in mood to not to be with Krishna. So when she was going two, three, four steps, he saw that there was a very poisonous snake. And when he saw Srimati Radhika, from other side he told, oh, raising his horse and he was hissing. Oh, Srimati Radhika was so much afraid. And telling, oh, Krishna, Krishna. And he ran and he fell in the lap of Krishna. Krishna was fell. He could not go. But the serpent made Srimati Radhika to again meet with. So Leenanukuram, so helpful for all these things. To eat snakes and scorpions and all others are helping in Krishna and Radhika serving. Anyhow. To what we speak others? So all are transcendental in Vrindavan. We should have eyes to see this. So Sukadeva Goswami was superior of Srimati Radhika. When Krishna pastimes were samapta hoga, completed, and he began to return to Guru Vrindavan with his all associates. Then Srimati and Radhika ordered this parrot that you should be in world. World needs you. Because when you will return to Golok Vrindavan, there will be none to save this world by Hari Katha. So you should be in this world and to save this world by Hari Katha. He began to be very बहुत जोर से रोने बेटर नहीं हाउ आई कैन बी विदाउट यू कंजुगल आई कैन नॉट बी इन दिस बट दे टोल्ड दैट वी विल गिव एम्पावर यू टू बी हियर एंड टू स्पीक हरि कथा इफ यू वेयर इन दिस वर्ल्ड एंड आफ्टर योर वर्क विल बी फिनिश्ड यू कैन कम देयर नो प्रॉब्लम सो दे returned to Golok Vrindavan and parrot was here. He was flying here and there, looking at where Harikatha is going. Without Harikatha he cannot be. So if there anywhere he was searching the places, he went in Kailash. And where Shankar was telling some this Harikatha, Bhagavad Katha, how Krishna came to this world. And he was explaining to his wife, Parvati Devi. From beginning she was hearing. And there on a branch of a tree, hiding himself, this parrot was there, hearing Katha. When in Srimad Bhagavat in third canto, he was explaining how creation was done, how all kinds of things were made, and other things. No interest, she being a lady devotee, she slept. But that parrot was very careful. He began to do one more, very good. Go on. Like in the mood of, in the voice like Parvati. And Shankar saw that, oh, Parvati is hearing everything and he went on. But when 10th canto was completed, and again 12th and 11th and 12th came, she walked
son.
And told, I was sleeping. I could not hear all these things. I want that. I request you to tell again. Then son cut off that. I told all these things in vain. But I saw that you are doing go on. Very good. Who was doing so? No, I have not heard all these things. So he began to look that who has such that who was doing like this? Like Parvati's voice. And he saw that in the branch of a very green tree, a reddish and there was a very good, a very beautiful boy. He took his finger and began to fall. I will kill this bird. Because being a unqualified person and he heard, in Gita, or in Srimad Bhagavat, Krishna has told to Arjuna in Gita that you should not tell this Srimad Bhagavat Gita to any unqualified person. If you are telling, then you will have felt so much offenses. So you should not. It will go without any fraud. So if you are telling all these things to any unqualified person, those who have no honor, you should not tell. So Srimad Bhagavat should not be told. But he is like a bird and he has heard, so I should kill. Otherwise he will be imitation guru and then he will be making so many offenses and problems and he will cheat others. So he wanted to kill. But at once that bird flew away and very nearer he came to Badrikashram. Though by air going only 4-5 miles. But now by bus or in vehicle or by on foot, it will take 1 month going there. So long distance. So in a moment he flew and Shankar took his trigon and began to follow. He was not so much durbal vyakti, ordinary person. He also walked in a sky and he began to flew and he followed. And the meantime that parrot came in the ashram cottage of Vyasadeva, where Vyasadeva was explaining Srimad Bhagavat same to his wife Bhitika Devi. And she was hearing all these things like very carefully. That it is like a nectar I am taking. So his mouth was open. And at once that bird can enter in his own. But there was no pain or anything. And he heard for 16 years or 12, some, no harm, 12 years or 16. I think that Bhagavat is in, divided in 12, so 12 years he heard. And after that, Vyasadeva told him, who you are in the womb of your mother? Now your mother is feeling some pain. Then she came, Shankar came and told, and searching there, Vyasadeva told, he did pranam to Shankar and Shankar did pranam to Rishi Prabhupada. And then Vyasadeva told, what you are searching? Have you seen any parrot coming here? Yes, I have seen. But why you are searching? I want to kill that bird. Why? Because he has heard Srimad Bhagavatam being unqualified. So I want to kill. Then Vyasadeva began to laugh. You know what is the result of hearing Srimad Bhagavatam? Yes, I know. What? He becomes ajar amar. Immortal. Then if he has become immortal, how you can kill him in that birth? You cannot kill. And he began to love. Then Shankar realized his whole mistake. And then he also began to love. And then he returned. Oh, Krishna has arranged everything. So, nothing to do. After that, after 12 years, Vyasadeva requested that, who are you in the womb of your mother? How you are giving pain? You should come out of it. The boy in womb told, I'm Sukh, but I cannot come. I can come in this same moment when any powerful person will take away this Maya from this world. And that moment I can come. He told that, I'm powerful, I can do like this. I'm taking whole Maya from here. You should just come. He told that, no, I have no faith. If Krishna will come and tell that, then I can come. At once, Vyasadeva remembered Krishna and Krishna came there. Then Krishna told, oh Parvati, you should come down from your mother. Om. He told them, who are you? I am Krishna. Oh, my namaskar to you. What do you want? You should come. He told that, I can come only when you take this Maya from this world. What is this Maya? Maya. There are two letters in this word. Ma means no. Ya means what you are realizing in this world. What you are thinking that I am this body, you are not this body. You are thinking that they are your father, mother, sister and all other things. And all belongs to you, wealth and animals and all the things. But your attachment which is with them, it is wrong thing. So Maya. Don't believe in this. So by the illusory power of whose Maya is going on like this, that I am this body, these are minds, this is called Maya. One fraction, what? Prakash? Manifestation of Jogmaya. This is Mahamaya. So if you will take Mahamaya, then I will come. It will say, yes, you can come very quickly. I am giving time that in a very short short, if some linseed seeds are given and they cannot be there for
even a fraction of a
second. I am giving time. And so you should come out. So Krishna did that. He at once came and run. Began to run. And Sukadeva Goswami, Vyasadeva, oh, he is out of Maya. He is transcendental. He is really qualified to hear Srimad Bhagavat that I have seen in my trance. So I want that this world should be this boy should study Srimad Bhagavatam with me. And then he should
preach
everywhere in this world Bhagavat Katha. By which all the by which whole world can be liberated. And they will have bhakti and thus Srimad Bhagavatam will be preached in the whole world. Then that thinking this, oh my son, he was falling. This should do one good. She should, you should pay something to.
Make a big feast.
If you are not doing that, I will see that you are not married her. We will get so much blessings and everything. You are joking, nothing to do.
Oh, a stand. We had a stand for this. Really? Yeah, that was cool. Pretty sure they gave it to us. And I believe I gave it to somebody. When they came in to LA, then they gave us two stands. One belonged to our mother.
तुम्हारा राग कट न जाए, ताल कट जाता है थोड़ा सा, और बाकी बहुत सुंदर, वेरी गुड, यू शुड लर्न दैट ये कभी राग टूट न जाए, बेताल में और सब ठीक, बहुत सुंदर, इसको फिर से कल से अभ्यास करना, एक जगह दूसरी जगह का,
it was somebody else's
turn, तो तीन साल इतना, then Vyasa was following. Why? Not he was attached to his son. Because he wanted to initiate that war. And to, through him he wanted to preach Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam is a high class of. It is the essence of all Ved, Upanishad, Puran, Shastra, Mahabharata, Ramayana, everything. Which is in Bhagavat is not even anywhere, and anywhere it is anything, it is must be in Srimad Bhagavat. Nigam kalpataror galitang phalam chukamukhadam ritadavasan pivata bhagavatam rasamalajam muhur pabhuvibhav. We will explain it afterward, but I am going to. So Srimad Bhagavat is like essence of all Srimad, Ved and Upanishad. Gita is only essence of Upanishads, Sarva Upanishado Gau. That all the Upanishads are like cow, and milk is Srimad Bhagavatam, Gita, and Krishna is milkman, and coffee is Arjun. And it is not only Arjun for whole world, that means. But Srimad Bhagavatam is essence of all the Vedas, including Mahabharata, Gita, and all the essence of all. Gita is not Russia, but Srimad Bhagavatam is Russia. Nigam kalpator galitam Russian. Vedas are like tree. The rush is there, but we cannot taste. If you are choosing, okay? Talking the root of trees of mango. You are shocking branches. You are shocking flowers. You cannot. If you are taking fruits of mangoes, green, not mature, rust will not come. When it will ripen, and any parrot will smell and give it touch by the mouth. Or not all, it should be ripened so much. Then itself coming from its branch, even in touch of air or without, when it will ripen, it will come. Then it will be so sweet and we can taste. So we cannot take it, this rust from the trees like Kalpavriksha, Vedas, Upanishads, Puran, even to Gita, that rust will not come. When it will come in the shape of Srimad Bhagavatam, and especially by the mouth of Sukadeva Goswami, who was he? He was associates of Radhika and Krishna. So it will be more sweeter. So Sukadeva Goswami, he thought that Sukadeva Goswami is so qualified person in this whole world. I should make him study Srimad Bhagavatam. He should hear. I am not searching anyone in this world who is qualified to study Srimad Bhagavatam. So he was being like, O son, O son, O son. but trees were echoing. When he went some distance, some very beautiful Gandharvas, wives of Gandharva, they were playing in the water, any pond, good pond. So many lotus were there, so fragrant air was blowing. And they were naked and they were playing to each other, drink water like this. And in the meantime, Sukadeva Goswami passed. They never looked at him. They were playing. But when they are there, being aged so much, 200 years, 300, become some old, so much white beard and long hairs, with also white, and he was falling. Then they became some ashamed. They came out of pond, they took their garments, and they, on the head, hidden in any tree, say, and they were doing pranam to Vyasadeva. Vyasadeva came nearer to them and asked, my dear daughters, why you assembled with me? I am so much old, and my son, his age is like 12, he is naked, and he is going, you have no assent for her, he, and now, why you are asking? You can come in my laps, like father and mother, more than that, and you are asking with me. They told that your son being at the age of 12, he was nothing to ask with us, that who are you, wood or stone or anything. And he was in trance like that, and he was gone. And you saw that we are girls, and you are coming to me and asking why. So you have sensed that we are ladies and you are male and we are female. So you have. What is shame, he that never knows that. What is shame? Like this cloth, his body is there. Nothing to cover. This body is also like cover. So what is the use of cover to cover? So he is going, and we have no shame. But now, look in you. Oh, you are saying that you are naked. And after that you became covered, your this body. That is why. But Sukadeva Goswami went into this very deep forest, like birds here and there. Next day, Vyas wanted to suck that poem and to bring it. So he took one poem of Srimad Bhagavatam and gave it to the hunters, that you should go, and this is a very powerful mantra. If you will chant this mantra in forest, all kinds of birds and what you want, all will be collected. Very easy. So you should go. And he went, and they began to shout this mantra. Varaha apidam natavarabhu karnayo karnikaram vipradabhasa kanak kapisham vayjayanti Randrana Vain Rather Sudha Puriyan Gopabinde Bandaranam Sabadaranam Pravishatavita Gento. This is the best slok for the beauty of Krishna. Krishna is going with lakhs and lakhs cows, with lakhs and lakhs cowherd boys like Dham, Shidham, Sudham, Vasudham, Sto, Krishna, Madhumangal, Shuval, and all others, Arjun, Ujjwal, playing them with them and shouting sometimes. Cows like dhiri dhiri means slowly, slowly, slowly. They are there. Not running here. Tiri tiri, oh, you want to take water? Tiri tiri tiri, come on. In the bank of this pond, the Jamuna. Niri niri means, oh, you should take water. Choo 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 choo. And drinking, like this. Playing with the pond. All. Boys are clapping sometimes, dancing with Krishna. They are going one forest to another forest. Krishna, these clothes are like very lightning. And his body is like Megharshyam. Megharshyam means?
New cloth.
Not black. So much beautiful. Krishna is most beautiful. Not black. But love. And new clothes. Taking full of so much water there. As if water is going to
rain.
Sorry. And Banmala is there. Banmala means five or seven kinds of wildflowers. And some Tulsi Manjari is there. And we are hammering on these. Amin. And all the boys are Kanaiya, Jai Kanaiya Lal, they are doing this. And thus Krishna is going. And some food friends are there. And in fruit friends are, there are 19 kinds of symptoms. Vajra, Bhaja, Ankush, Pataka and so. Everything is there. So he is doing now. This. Also Brahma and Pun. Nomidhyate abhravapushe talitambaraya gunjavatansa paripachal sanmukhaya. Sanmukhaya bakkolasaitat vetravishana venu lakshmasriye midupate pasupangajaya. So, but this sloka is most powerful. Hearing this, he came at once. From where you learned this sloka? Oh my Gurudev has taught. And so many birds came in their net. Then they became so happy and he told that, I want to meet your Gurudev. But what is the quality? This is the shape of beauty of Krishna. But how merciful he is, I want to know. Then he went to Vyasadeva and were very happy that so many birds has come in their net. And they told that a very beautiful boy came to us naked and he told that if that Krishna is so beautiful, what are these qualities? Then he told that you should read this shloka and so many words again will come. Then he told, Aho Vakiyam Stanakalakutam Jighansayagayatayakka Sadhi Lehe gatin tato dhatu kajuta Kongva dayalum saranam brajema Kongva dayalum saranam brajema. Oh, you want to hear? So you should repeat this in the forest. That Aho Baki in Stanakalakutam Aho Baki, the sister of Bakasur, that is Putana. He took so much
strong poison
is her breast and came in the shape of very doting mother and he wanted to kill Krishna. He took at once Krishna in his or her lap and gave breast forcibly in the mouth of Krishna. And Krishna swapped that poison with her
life.
And he left his body and she died. But Krishna was so merciful that he made her atma so pure, so pure, and he gave the same position like mother. And she at once went to Golok Vrindavan, Golok, and there she became eternal like mother, Dhatri Gati. Dhatri means sometimes giving bread, milk to Krishna. So, Krishna is how merciful? So, in this world, those who have some intelligence, they should surely do bhajan of Krishna. Those who are not serving and having no devotional service to Krishna, actually they are like a donkey without any horn. And their leg, their tail is also cutting.
Tailless.
Tailless. and hornless. Especially that two legs has been cutting down. So these persons, all are like donkeys, those who are not serving, uttering the name of Krishna, singing and hearing. Then he heard at once, he came. And he came to Vyasa, told, I want to read, study whole Srimad Bhagavatam. And he studied there. And now he is praying to Vyasadeva. I was in the way of Nirvishesh Brahma. Nirgunya api parinishthita. I have so much fixed my intelligence in Nirvishesh Brahma. But this Nirvishesh Brahma is different from Sankar Brahma.
Sankar
Sampradaya. Right? That Sankar Sampradaya are offender. But he was not offended. His Brahma was nirvishesh, no akar, no shape, but so much qualities. His Brahma is so merciful, but Shankar nothing. Having no shape, no attribute, no power, nothing. Like Jiva or Buddha, so much different. And he began to study, and after that he became so learned and so sweet, knowing all the rasas. And then he came in the council of Parikshit Maharaj, and he was uttering Srimad Bhagavatam. Gaur Praman. Panchatattva and then Maha.
Andrew.